Paul is amazing. Amazing to work with.
The Telling Tales project actually grew out of the notion of the creative campus, and that was something that evolved out of a conference that took place at Columbia University a number of years ago. But the purpose of the project is to infuse artists into the classroom and to promote interdisciplinary thinking, the goal of which is student creative work.
The story starts out with these brave warriors having fought through thick and thin with each other on their noble quest for the Holy Orange Juice Springs.
Telling Tales Project is about creative collaboration. And what I mean by that is students work in teams, learning and listening to other students who have different backgrounds and different life experiences. So when everybody puts all these pieces together, they get to understand the course material or the topic in a different and deeper way.
Brave! Yes, more body energy there, excellent.
So why is this important? Well, from all the people that I've talked to, professors, school administrators, business people, they say that these are the skills that the students are really gonna need in order to be successful out in the world, especially the workplace. My strategy in a Telling Tales workshop was to use theater techniques. For example, I use movement, storytelling, an ensemble. And I make an effort to make it accessible for anybody. You don't have to be a dancer or an actor to be successful.
The students come in as separate people. They're going to get separate grades. For them to work together is not necessarily a natural thing. Yet the start of them working together all happened with Paul's class and the Telling Tales workshop.
In Bob Miranda's class, I was told that much of what they're doing is solo stand-up comic routines. So I suggested this. Why don't we have them work in ensemble where they write material together? And the reason for this is that when people work together, they often come up with ideas that they didn't expect. It's difficult to work alone, but when you're working with the people, it loosens you up. And the second thing was I wanted them to have something that had to do with their own lives, because that is the best source of material. So the prompt in this case was, what's college life like? And the piece that you see on the video was based on a story that someone told about Sunday morning pressing the button on an elevator, the door opening, and seeing a bunch of college students pass out on the floor. And this is their interpretation of that story.
I felt like if I taught contemporary politics, that students would tune out. And so I thought that if people were telling their own stories about work, because the course was really concerned with questions of work, that I had a better chance of getting them to really sort of absorb the ideas. And they're very abstract, complex, and provocative and controversial ideas. So I took a leap of faith that having artists come work with us would make a big difference in how easily the material was assimilated.
Maureen said to me, Paul, how can I make this material in this course come alive? And I suggested, why don't we come up with a prompt that most of the students can relate to? So we agreed on this. Have you or anyone you ever known experienced discrimination while on a job? And one particular story resonated for me. A young lady was talking about every time she needed to go to a restroom break, the male manager clocked her. And when she came back, he let her know that she was gone for too long or something like that. And yet when the guys went to the restroom, they took their time, they had a cigarette break, they talked to the male manager. She said, that was my experience of discrimination. And after she finished speaking, this young male student looked at her and said, that really happened to you? Suddenly the course material came alive.
Watching him work and break it down into exercises, and then watching him help my students take their stories and build them into composites. They were also so fully engaged and they were having fun that it was a joy really to watch. There's nothing like telling a story to learn things that are foreign.
There was something that was in the back of my mind about Cortázar, right? How to transmit, how to communicate the content and the conceptual abstract aspects of the literature. And So that when this opportunity came up, I thought, you know, I had a great match.
This was right up my alley, because what I do as a theater performer is take the text and figure out how to translate it for the stage. What movements do I use? What images do I create? What sound effects? Where do I stand? How do I condense the material into something that still captures the meaning of what's on the page? So the students took a story called The Island, written by Cortázar, and I gave them the parameter that it had to be a minute long, and they had to use the ideas that behind the text. They had to figure out, what does this mean? What is he trying to say? And make it understandable for an audience. So at the end of the day, what did the students learn from Telling Tales? They learned that there's more than one way to understand course material, there's more than one way to understand themselves, and more than one way to understand the world around them. And professors have told me, who've used Telling Tales in their courses, that it creates a sense of community in the classroom. A sense of community that takes advantage of all the different backgrounds and experiences that students can bring to a class and puts it to use in a positive way to create a better learning environment.
Working with Paul is going to yield unpredictably, unexpectedly fantastic results.
By the time they left, they weren't just, you know, colleagues or collaborators, they were really friends.
In the process of doing this work, they've discovered something about themselves that will be with them the rest of their lives.